Now, the most accurate weather forecast in South Texas with meteorologist Juan Acuna.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back and a very good Monday afternoon to you. We're starting off with our Rockport weather bug that's looking out in beautiful Rockport. You can see lots of sunshine. We had the clouds early in the morning, but as we look at temperatures right now, it is fairly warm out there in Kingsville. You finally broke the 90 degree mark, so it's a pretty hot day for you folks there. Our water temperature has warmed up to 71, but it ranges from 86 out in Rockport all the way down to Ingleside and even here in the city, and as high as 89 out around George West and Three Rivers as well. Our frontal boundary came in early this morning, so everyone is holding on to northerly winds. It seems kind of odd to have a northerly wind and temperatures in the 80s or 90s, but the really cool air is lagging far up to the north of us, but the dry air is already in with the dew points into the 20s and 30s, and it's just struggling to get to the coastline, but it'll eventually push offshore. And right now the 24-hour dew point changes are really, really significant, anywhere between 20 up to 40 degrees less than what it was yesterday. So basically hot and it was warm and humid yesterday. Today it's hot, but there's not quite as much moisture in the air. But with the dry air in place and with the warm temperatures and the breezy northerly winds, we do have red flag warnings in effect for our western counties. That does include Duval, Jim Hogg, and Brooks County. Now, the red flag warning essentially means that there is a pretty high fire danger out there. And with those relative humidities being pretty low, the strong winds and the warm temperatures, it can contribute to extreme wildfire behavior. So use caution, and that remains in effect until this evening. There's that little disturbance that went through. There was nothing severe about it. There were just really light sprinkles, even a couple of lightning strikes associated with it, but it quickly moved up to the northeast, and right now in the Victoria Crossroads, we're just dealing with a couple of little clouds that are hanging on to the coast right now, but up to the north of us, there's a secondary surge. That's where most of the cool air lies, and it's going to continue to push on down to the south. And up to the north and northeast of us, that's where the low pressure system is. Out to the southeast, that's where they're expecting a big flare-up of showers and storms, and some of that could get pretty severe. But up to the north, they're into the 30s and 40s. We might not get that cold. We could clip the upper 40s the next couple of mornings, but that's going to be reserved for our northern sections and inland areas of the coastal bend, as we have 50 up in Amarillo right now. There goes the disturbance off to the east of us. And as we look at the future tracker over the next several days, look what comes and visits us. High pressure will take over the forecast, and that's going to mean pretty nice conditions, actually. We'll have a little bit of dry air that'll linger. And then as we go into the Wednesday, Thursday time frame, that's when we'll look for temperatures to start to really warm up. But for this evening, looking at mainly clear skies, eventually dropping into the upper 60s on our way to the lower 50s early in the morning. And notice those northerly winds start to take more of a southerly shift, going around 5 to 10 miles an hour. So for tomorrow, it is going to be an absolutely gorgeous day. Afternoon highs, we're going to trade the 80s and 90s for the upper 70s with north-northeasterly winds around 9 to 18 miles an hour, with forecast highs into the lower 70s near the coast, upper 70s here in the city, and lower 80s out into the inland area. So for tomorrow, we're going to expect that front to push through. It's going to be a gorgeous day out there. And then as we head into Wednesday, it's still going to be very, very nice over South Texas. So 53, 78 tomorrow, 54 and 70 on Wednesday, and then it really warms up along with increasing winds headed on into the weekend, with highs back into the middle 80s and overnight lows into the upper 60s and lower 70s. Lee.